Let's play this narrative January 6th. Imagine this. Imagine what I'm about to show you right now. And you're like looking at this and you're like, what? Was the pipe bomb real? Was the pipe bomb fake? Some people are saying they look like training pipe bombs that the FBI does. And this is in front of the DNC. I'm going to set this up. This is in front of the DNC. This is President, this is Vice President-elect Kamala Harris. She's in this building right now. So she has Secret Service and all them looking at out front. You know, they're just doing detail, making sure nobody's up to no good. You know what I'm saying? Bang, 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 bang. But let's play this. I was going to play all the videos. Like, if you go to the Rock and Roll Rebel on Twitter, you can see the 7-minute video. There's no audio, but I found this clip that we're going to play. It's 4 minutes long, and it should blow people's minds. It should blow people's minds. And I understand people are busy and they don't care. They don't care so much, but we're going to have to. We're going to have to. If we don't, it's going to be like the Roosevelt Hotel in New York City. I don't know if you know about the most famous hotel in New York City, the Roosevelt, but it's full of migrants. The migrants are there living free. They're in cell phones, whatever. And, that's what we're going to do. Let's just get through this. Even though it is Friday night, we're having fun. Hopefully a couple people out there, you know, this, they're getting it. You know what I'm saying? Let me just carry on. Because I don't want to get too hype. And we're going to lay back. Let's play the video. Did I hype the video too much? I'm hyping the video too much. They're like, he won one tonight. But let's see here. Let's pull this up. Oh, my. All right, here we go. This is Tucker Carlson and Darren Beatty, right? Is that what I said? So let's pull this up and let's play this. And we're going to react after this.
And it's really remarkable. What it depicts is the discovery of the DNC bomb at approximately 1:05 p.m. on January 6th. And if you follow the timestamps closely, you can see this guy in a backpack come into frame at around 1:05. What he does is he first approaches a car, which is a Metro PD car, talks to the driver's side in the window for a while, then moves to the other side of the window, and then eventually moves and chats with somebody in a black SUV, which is a Secret Service car, chatting with Secret Service. In fact, we've learned through multiple sources that the Metro PD was part of that Secret Service detail. Why was the Secret Service there? We'll get to that in due course. But the guy finishes Kamala talking to the SUV and then leaves the frame. What the individual in the backpack is doing is alerting the Metro PD and the Secret Service of the fact that there is a pipe bomb just feet away that was planted by the park bench outside of the DNC. Now, for those watching this video, and everyone has to watch this video to follow along, the first thing that will strike you as remarkable is just how utterly unconcerned both the Metro PD and the Secret Service are about being informed that there was a pipe bomb literally within feet of them and within feet of their protectee, who was VP-elect Kamala.
Yeah, that's weird, because the guy comes up, talks in the car, goes to one side, like he said, goes to the other side, and then they don't come out to the car till a minute later. So maybe they're like radioing in, this guy came up to us and there's a pipe bomb. But wouldn't you be like, hold on, sir, come here. And like cuff him? He's like, who's doing that? Who goes to the cops and say there's a pipe bomb over there in the bush?
Kamala Harris. You'll notice if you watch from approximately 1:07 to 1:09 in the timestamp, utterly lackadaisical, utterly unconcerned. Takes them minutes to even get out of their vehicles, at which point they're just kind of lingering around, uninterested, unconcerned. And then this alone is enough to be a national scandal and blow open this investigation with with severity. And that is the Secret Service, the Metro PD, you'll see this, I couldn't believe it when I saw it. They allow a group of children cross the street in the direction of the pipe bomb and allow the children to walk within feet of the park benches where the pipe bomb was planted. The Secret Service agent as well is walking right with the children within feet of this bomb. Then, about a minute later, a Capitol Police officer walks even closer to the bomb, takes a picture of it, gives a thumbs up sign, leaves, after which point the Metro PD car, the Secret Service car leave, and then the video is over. Now, I know from very reputable sources who have seen the extended video that minutes after that, they have a bomb-safe robot come to dismantle and defuse this bomb. Now, people listening to this are probably asking themselves, first of all, why the unconcern from the Secret Service and the...
Yeah, none of that makes no sense to me. There's a 7-minute version. Go to my Twitter at Rock and Roll Rebel, and you can see all that. But here's what we're up against. This is the problem we're up against. So the FBI looks like they probably planted a bomb because they were so nonchalant. You know what I'm saying? Why would you care if you already knew it was a fake? And then also in this interview, I guess the camera, when they're in the park where they have the pipe bomber, the frames per second were cut down. Like most cameras are like the bare minimum, like your trash cameras are 8 frames per second. The one that they showed you on TV of the pipe bomber is 1.6. So you know it's altered. Like if you go into your old gas stations and those big white boxes that are pointing down, those are 8 frames per second. It's garbage. You know what I mean? But it's enough to catch a still image, and then it's still grainy. But the FBI, of course, got software and all that stuff. So I don't know what to tell you all. I don't know what to tell you all. It's you got to get out and vote. You got to get out and vote. Wait till I give my. You got to get out and vote. If you do not get out and vote, you do not call your representatives. I know you're busy. Spread the word. There's people out here that are watching this. My Uncle T, he out there watching it. I Trust 45 on Twitter. Go to his. He's blowing up the whole scene. He's got the best retweets and tweets of all time. Follow him. And for the rest of y'all out there, like and subscribe, baby. Like and subscribe. There's only 2 things that we can do out here is live or die. That's our only options. I plan on living, baby. Are you?